describe it to you, other than to say that it's kind of an interactive tattoo.
Oh.
Yep. Pinocchio's got a full head of hair, and if you get me horny, he looks like he's lying.
And they won't print that.
They won't take a picture of it.
Yeah, that's terrible. Well, Mr. Rieger, good luck. I understand you're hoping to have 350 tattoos by this Christmas, and eventually 500 tattoos. That's outstanding.
I have 500 tattoos.
Wow! All 101 Dalmatians. Do they all have names?
Oh, I don't name them all. I number them.
Oh, okay.
I'll tell you what. Number 63 hurt like a bitch. Hey, I wonder if you guys can help me out.
I don't know.
Do you know a good plastic surgeon?
Why?
Pinocchio's got these two big moles right up.
I see.
Thinking about having those lanced.
Maybe just have them lopped off. Well, thanks a lot, Mr. Rieger.
Okie dokie.
Okay. Be careful with that needle.
Hey, Christy.
Yes.
You want to come over here and rub a lad's magic lamp?
Oh, no, that's okay. Thank you, though.
Righty.
What I thought we would do is we have a special new treat here.
Oh, we do?
Okay. Yeah, I thought we would, a little preview. I thought we would get to of our Christmas album.
All right.
And I thought we'd play this right now, then we'll get to sports in a second.
Is this a Christmas song?
No.
Oh,
no, this is I won't say anything, but this is a brand new song though. I think you're going to enjoy it, so listen with care.
Now that you are, there's only one thing I'd like you to do, my dear. Honey, pull up my skirt, undo my blouse, peel off my pantyhose. Baby, take off my bra and my spikes. Honey, take off all of my clothes. Take them all off, baby. My clothes again, honey, I will file for divorce. Bob, that skirt doesn't even go with that blouse. Now put on this apron and go do the dishes.
Surprise!
Yeah, it was her blouse.
It was.
Okay.
And her eye healed.
We'll come right back with sports at 7:27.
This Futon Factory. The Futon Factory.
Yeah.
The Futon Factory.
Yeah. The Futon Factory.
7:31 at Q95. You're with Bob and Tom. Good morning.
Good morning. A few minutes ago, we heard a brand new song called The Encounter. That's Victoria Fredericks. That'll be featured on our forthcoming...
Victoria Fredericks.
That'll be
you
featured.
You failed to tell us that earlier.
I was trying to get it out, but I couldn't get a word in edgewise for some reason this morning. Good morning. You're on Q95 with Bob and Tom. We're going to do Chick McGee Sports in just a second. A couple of guests to introduce. First off, comedian Todd Yon has just joined us in the studio. Todd, good morning.
Good morning.
And Todd has been featured on our last couple of albums. We'll talk to Todd in a second. And also a guest now, the former regular on the program, but now a brand new mommy. It's Pat Carlini calling from her house. Pat, good morning.
Hi, guys. Good morning.
Well, this phone's much better than Channel 13, isn't it?
Yeah, sound better?
Yes.
Now, Pat, I drove by your house last night, and I noticed that the lights were on, and I saw John inside looking very tired, so I decided not to go knock and say hello. How's the baby?
Well, now you can come by any time. It's gotten a lot easier. Yeah, she's fine, and it's just those first few days are like, wow.
And the last thing you want to do is answer the phone, isn't it, Pat?
Yeah, it's pretty crazy. It's really funny, but I figure this, you know, no sleep thing will last, just about 18 years or so?
Exactly. No. It'll get better.
Yeah.
Although it'll get different.
Yeah, but in 18 years.
Yeah, in 18 years it'll get better. But
yeah, you'll be staying up till 1, 2 o'clock wondering where the hell she is.
Yeah, it'll always be something. But she does pretty well at night. She's asleep right now, but she'll sleep about a big 4 hours at night. So that sounds like, you know, that's a long stretch.
Mm-hmm. Now, are you breastfeeding or are you bottle feeding?
Yeah, breastfeeding for now.
Good for you. Good for the baby. Good for you.
Maybe for another week. That's possible.
That's a lot of work. It hurts. You know, 18 years from now when she's on Oprah going, if only my mommy had breastfed me that day.
You know, she was a weather woman and she's a baby idiot.
I wouldn't have set the school on fire if I had a big juicy jug to chug on. So don't feel guilty about it.
No.
And, you know, also, I remember telling you this earlier, I read an article indicating that nutritionists and doctors indicate that if you breastfeed, it's one of the only ways for women to reduce the fat in their thighs.
Yeah, it just sucks everything out of you. I think mm-hmm. that's why, but you can definitely tell that, you know, things start to return to normal.
Well, if you need some help, I'll help you take a few pounds off.
I'll get over there and tap a quart, Patty.
So you're feeling
down to fighting weight.
You're feeling pretty good, Pat. Little Nicolette's doing fine. That's great. How much hair does she have?
She has a full head of hair still. I don't know if that'll fall out. I guess sometimes it falls out and comes back, but mm-hmm. she has a lot of hair. But I've heard Christy's dream. Now I've heard about this.
No, is Nicolette's hair real dark?
It was when she was born. So mm-hmm. The delivery guy yesterday actually brought some flowers and said, hey, Christy said, can I see the baby has really dark hair?
No, I dreamt that the baby had coal black hair and that you brought her in for us to see her for the very first time and you had dyed your hair black to match the baby's. Cute kid, had real curly black hair, but it was hysterical.
It's mine!
Do you want to hear about my dream I had about tiling the kitchen floor with John Mellencamp?
No. We heard about it yesterday.
Never mind that.
So, Pat, did you end up having a C-section or were you okay now?
No, I had it the normal way.
Oh, okay.
And I guess that went very quickly. It was only 4 hours of labor and she was ready to go. Yep. So I didn't even have to go through I know some have gone through many, many hours of that.
Right.
So.
Mm-hmm.
Now, did you fry up the placenta?
Oh, chick.
Oh, God, I see you haven't changed a bit.
So are you going to call Nicolette cultures. Nikki?
Well, everybody's been calling her Nicole, so I guess it just kind of takes on a...
Nicole.
You know.
Nicole. Oh, bad sign.
That's not good.
Well, don't let her drink any OJ out of
it. Yeah.
And Nick, wow. And my whole mother's side just calls her Gracie, because, you know, Grace is her middle name. That was my grandmother's name.
Mm-hmm. So, told you. Gracie's a good name.
Gracie's a great name.
Yeah. My uncle, my mother, the whole bunch.
So your kid's going to grow up as a schizophrenic.
Right.
As a parent.
It's a lonely world, Pat. Don't let her.
It's always a good idea.
It's a lonely world. It is not. It's a lonely world. It is not.
We'll have just chick to talk to.
Yep, me. Just mean me and Gracie at the meeting.
But yeah, her hair is getting a little bit lighter. But yeah, at first it was pretty funny. It was just dark and curly, and I just told everybody it was Bob's. You know,
oh, fine.
Perfect. It's Bob's child.
It's perfect. Mine.
Wow.
It's a miracle, baby.
It is a miracle.
It's a miracle, baby. Well, they went swimming together in a pool in Disney World, and well,
I was both Chick and I were present for Bob's vasectomy. So if it is his child, you must have had it with one of those test tube things.
No, that wouldn't even have done it.
You haven't been hanging around the lab, have you?
Wait a minute. Tom Cochran has dark hair.
Have you ventured out with Nikki yet?
You know, I just did a little bit yesterday, and today we have to go to the doctor, and that's like the first big trip.
Ah.
I have to put her in the car myself and go, you know, in my little convertible.
Good. Pat, don't drop her.
No, I won't drop her.
Jeez.
Don't drop her.
Don't get her head stuck in a revolving door or anything.
You're a big boy.
Or leave her sitting on top of the car as you drive off.
We forgot the baby!
What was that?
Pulled out backwards. Yeah, she's so that should be interesting. That's this afternoon, so I think after this. I think I'll even stop in next week.
Oh, good.
Okay, fine.
Oh, yes, I'd love to. Hold her.
Well, yeah. Thanks for calling, Pat. Good luck. We won't bother you anymore. We just wanted you to check in, make sure you were okay.
Oh, no, that's fine. I've heard from everybody that's called and come to the door and said, oh, are you here? You got to call. They're talking about you.
So, we only had to call three times to get you to call back, Pat.
I know.
Well, it's no wonder. It sounds like a frat house calling when we leave a message. Hey, Ava, eat me.
I don't ever remember once yelling out, eat me.
No, I did.
Oh, okay.
I yelled out, eat me.
Oh, I saved that message. That was
did you? Okay. Yeah. That's for the trial.
So now, are the have the whole everyone in the family come in to see the baby? Has your sister been in?
Yes. Yes, everybody's been in to see her. That was the first week. So that is a real nutty time. And Everybody checked her out, and they all go home. But now she even changes within 2 weeks. They start to change a little bit, you know, because at first they kind of have that little cone head and, and everything. So their nose is kind of smashed, you know, and now she's starting to look like a little person.
Good. Well, good. I can imagine, since I have three young children, I'm sure you probably have absolutely no taste for anything with mustard on it.
Oh, Tom.
Yeah.
Boy, that's true, isn't it?
Yeah.
I'll second that.
Although, I'll tell you what, Pat, let me just say this, and for any new parents out there, changing diapers becomes so second nature after a while.
Yep.
I actually one day caught myself on a cellular phone, standing there with a hot dog in my mouth, changing a diaper. Didn't even realize it.
No. Yeah. Oh, and wait, and Pat,
kind of propping the phone like this, hot dog in my mouth. Oh, okay, which dog? Changing a diaper.
I'll bet it wasn't a chili dog.
No, it was not a chili dog.
And wait till they get to be about two or three, and you're starting to, you know, try to have them potty trained, and they have a little accident, and it's like the movement of a middle-aged man. And it's unbelievable.
Pardon me, is that Great Poupon?
Well, Pat, have some fun and hope you get some rest today.
Yeah, well, thanks.
Okay.
I'll see you guys soon.
And I'm sure your doctor probably is the baby's doctor a man or a woman?
It's a man. The baby doctor's a man.
Okay, well, I hope he's got a good sense of humor because they can really scare you when they're this young. Oh, my God, Pat, I don't believe it. Just kidding. That's not.
I've never seen that before. Just kidding.
That's not really a third eye. That'll go away.
Oh, great. All right, Pat, you go to rest, and we'll talk to you later.
Okay. Give our best to John.
All right.
Okay, bye-bye.
Tell him to give a little kiss in the cheek to Consuelo.
And give him a...
Who's Consuelo?
Who's Consuelo?
Don't you pay attention to the show.
Apparently you're not.
That's John's imaginary mistress in Orlando.
Oh, that's right. That's in Florida.
Her, you know, Consuelo and Loopy.
Yeah.
Got one on each coast.
Okay.
Even the casual listener knows that we've created a fake mistress for John down in Florida. Come on, go with the program.
Even the most casual listeners knows that.
Don't have time to listen anymore.
Good morning, sports fans. Bob, Tom, Christy, Todd. Good morning.
Chick.
Morning.
Chick.
Antonio Davis doesn't start often, but when he does, he makes the most of it. He led the team 18 points, 11 rebounds, and a 113-104 victory over the Hornets last night at the arena. Pacers starting front court of Smits, Dale Davis, and Derek McKee sat the game out with injuries. Reggie said that if the Pacers can keep winning while struggling through injuries, they'll be better off in the long run. The Pacers' preseason record of 5-1, tops in the Eastern Conference. Reggie had 18 points. Michael Adams led Charlotte with 19. Well, when the Colts take the field against the Jets on Sunday at 4 o'clock at the RCA Dome, exclusive coverage right here on Q95 and 1260 WNDE, Don Majkowski will be your starting quarterback, replacing Jim Harbaugh. Coach Ted Marchibrota made the announcement yesterday, and here's the new quarterback, the Magic Man.
And we're watching the films from that game and so forth. I'm going to study that a lot and try to see some tips and so forth that maybe we might be able to improve on. Because they did some things that were pretty effective against us, and hopefully we can do a better job in some areas this time.
Well, for every up, there is a down. For every Majkowski, there is a Harbaugh, Jim.
So I'm fully behind Don and in his corner, and I'll do the best I can to help him out and help the rest of the team, and mainly just prepare myself for him needed again.
Did you catch that at the end?
Or I recommend reading this morning's sports page for some wisdom on this topic.
Colts rally in the alley with Jimmy Mad Dog May this Sunday at 1 p.m. Special 4 o'clock start time this week on Jackson Street. Beer and burgers only $1. Beer this week at the rally in the alley.
Yes.
Look out. Ice beat the Chicago Wolves in the IHL last night. Bob's Special K Kellogg scored with 4:50 remaining. Ice 5, Chicago 3. Tomorrow night, the Ice host Kalamazoo at Market Square Arena, and the Village People will have a special post-game concert. And I'll be your host. Thank you. Thank you very much.
So what is this arm thing you're doing?
YMCA. You spell that out.
Even Todd knows it. God, that's scary.
How do you know that, Todd?
From many years of a drunken stupor, I just adapted it.
Come on, do it.
All I know is it got me laid one night. That's all I care about.
There we go.
What was that?
He was wonderful. He was great. He was the Indian. Oh, I was a squaw.
That's scary.
I was a squaw bitch. That's what I was. Oh, my, that's a sharp arrow.
Village People, one of the great comic acts in the history of music.
Yeah.
For 2-3 years.
I'm still laughing. Wacky.
On top of the charts and then just instantly disappearing.
The hockey lockout.
Everybody found out they were gay, I think.
No, I don't think that was it.
We all
the hits just stopped coming.
That. I had no idea.
I didn't know.
I had no idea.
I did not
How
know.
How old were you?
18, 17.
I was 16.
Mm. I don't know how you could kind of miss
20,
that.
20, I don't know. Yeah, I didn't know.
It was kind of the era of, that whole era of Studio 54 and...
I swear I didn't know.
You know, Liza Minnelli and...
I didn't know.
The long cigarettes, lots of cocaine.
I didn't know it was wrong. The hockey lockout has reached 27 days. Out of work, Wayne Gretzky has told the Toronto Sun he's planning a European All-Star swing of 4 to 6 games. However, the Players Association has yet to sanction the Gretzky tour. Frank Thomas has again captured the American League Most Valuable Player Award for 70% of the season, minus the playoffs and the World Series. Baseball writers gave the nod to the eagle-eyed White Sox first baseman. Who the hell's writing this? He had batted .353, 38 home runs, and walked 100 times. Also had a lot of RBIs.
Thanks for the stats, Chick.
Okay,
we appreciate
thank
it.
You very much. The baseball writers...
He was tackled by a number of Colts. Thank you.
Godby Brothers would like to present. Baseball writers will vote for the National League MVP. That'll be announced today. The Players Union gets another visit from Bill Asheray.
Asheray.
Today is his brother, Bob. Very confused when he filled out the SAT.
Asheray Bob. My God, I got the answer.
Asheray Bob.
Asheray Bob.
Corporal Asheray Bob reporting for duty. The federal mediator continues to gather information on the baseball strike, and there's no end in sight. Here's something fun. New York Mets reliever John Franco, who hasn't played in how long? What, 6 months?
Years.
He's apparently added a physical aspect to the baseball strike. The New York Times quotes Franco as saying about strike breakers, if somebody crosses the picket line, once we get back in and start playing, I'll be the first one to throw at him. Franco's teammate Bobby Bonilla, also going after the Pulitzer in peace, has issued a threat to players who break ranks. The Met Star tells a Northern New Jersey paper that the baseball dispute is like any other labor situation. As Bonilla puts it, try to cross a Teamster's line and you'll end up in the East River.
With the fishes.
With the fishes, we'll break some
heads. That's where Bonilla's career has pretty much ended up.
In the East River.
The difference here is the parking lot for the picketers is full of Rolls Royces, Jaguars, yeah. Porsches.
Yeah.
The Teamsters are just trying to make ends
meet. I say, Jeeves, did you ring the sign?
Yeah. Walk the picket line for me some more, will you? Thank you very much.
Is that the way you spell arbitration? I never really went to class. I didn't know that.
I had another butler going to class for me at that time.
I always thought it started with an R.
Arbitration.
Did it?
However, good news for pro basketball fans. An anonymous source, Deep Throat, tells the AP that the union and owners will have a positive announcement today regarding the NBA labor dispute. Reportedly, the sides are close to a no-lockout, no-strike pledge that would allow the season to start as planned a week from tomorrow, negotiations to continue to hammer out an agreement. Earlier reports stated that the owners had been scheduled to take a lockout vote on Monday in Chicago. Several sources, though, say the sides have been talking in recent days. No formal negotiations have been held in 3.5 months. The basic agreement expired with the playoffs in June. Boston Celtics are going to bring down the curtain at Boston Garden by honoring greats from their storied past during various games this coming season. The NBA team will stage a halftime salute to former coach and current president Red Auerbach on opening night next month. The Celtics will move into the next door to the Chaumont Center.
The Chaumont?
Chaumont. That was the original name of Boston, I believe, was Chaumont. Next fall, we'll also retire number 35, the late Reggie Lewis. I think it was Chaumont.
Did not know that.
I didn't either.
Chaumont, Massachusetts.
Who named it that? The Indians?
Fwad.
Fwad?
Farquhar.
Hafez, Yitzhak, Smark, Fwad, Farquhar.
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 Chaumont.
I don't know. I made
right
it up.
Down the road from Kismet.
I made it up. It's fate that we name it Chaumont.
Now, the Boston Garden basketball floor, according to Reggie Miller, is
the worst
floor in the NBA. The
Boston Garden is...
Always has been. And the Boston Garden is like a
mess. It's scary.
There's no...
So is that,
I told you that story.
Will that be a parking lot soon?
I don't know. Cab driver dropped me off, and I go... Where's the arena?
Rats.
It goes right there. It looks like a subway station.
Yeah.
It's scary, doesn't it? Yeah.
Rats and bats and elephants and all kinds of things running wild in there.
Wow.
Wow.
Not anymore.
Not anymore.
But for me, Teddy Kennedy, it reminds me of the many, many women that I have scored while...
in the parking lot.
Briefly attending the games, picking up a few chicks for some trim.
Sports this morning on Q95.
Speaking of Kennedy, I got a call from Kennedy from yesterday. Q95, who's this?
Good morning, Senator Kennedy calling.
Senator, how are you?
Fine, I'm on the turnpike. I hope you can hear me all right. We're throwing $100 bills out the window right now, getting more voters.
Oh, well, good.
Good luck.
Yes, thank you. Boy, I tell you, I've had too much to drink this morning. I've been, I knew I did when I was out kissing people and shaking babies. God, I hate that when it happens.
Can you,
Hey, listen.
Do you have an exotic drink that you enjoy?
I most certainly do. It's called a Chappaquiddick.
Oh. Really?
It's a, yes, Scotch and murky water. Let me tell you something. If you have one, you better brace yourself. All right.
Thank
Goodbye
you,
now.
Senator.
Hello, ladies. How are you? Look at the anaconda.
And we're watching the films from the...
Oh, shut up. There we are.
I believe we have someone on the phone there explaining the Shawmut.
Oh, do we?
Name.
Okay.
Yeah.
Morning Q95, who's this?
This is Tim Halford.
Hi, Tim. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
You can clear up the Shawmut incident?
I can clear it up.
What does it mean?
Shawmut is a bank there that financed the new arena, kind of like what happened here with the Hoosier Dome.
Ah.
And also, the Boston Garden is a dump. You share your seat with rats and everything else.
Jeez.
So I don't think they're going to miss it too much other than the tradition.
But you don't know if Shawmut was the original name of Boston or not?
No, it's a number of banks there in Worcester, Massachusetts, and down in Boston is how they, as I understand, that's how they got it.
Is it Shawmut Stadium or the Shawmut Center? Or
I think it's the Shawmut Center, yeah.
The Shawmut Center.
Shawmut.
Okay.
Wow.
Well, thanks. Well, thank you.
Tim, appreciate it.
Shawmut.
Okay. That was much better than the guy with the bourbon yesterday.
Yes.
Sports this morning brought to you by Cocktail Cove. Wear a costume Saturday night and win bags and bags of prizes, including $400 cash for the best costume, $1.25 long necks, and 2.25 Long Islands all night long. Coming Thursday, November 3rd, the Cove gets live with party band Rock Doll.
Call suppose if a giraffe walked into a bar and said, I'd like a beer.
Long neck?
And the bartender said, long neck. Would he go, what do you think?
What do you think?
What do you mean,
ass?
Wise guy? Would I?
Hair lip?
Would I?
Dumpy?
I'd like a drink, please. Okay, Mr. Giraffe. Long neck?
Would I?
You bastard.
Hair lip? Call 576-9800 for more information. That's the Cocktail Cove.
Sure it is.
By the way,
get a long neck at the Cocktail Cove.
By the way, this traveling microphone will be at, there's nobody handier than I am. And I'll be at the new Lowe's this afternoon at like 6 o'clock, I think, at 71st.
That'll be this evening.
Michigan.
You are going to be at a handyman store?
Yeah.
Don't turn on the power tools, you might cut off your arm.
I'm going to be redoing some things, and we'll be giving away some Q stuff. That's this evening, I guess.
Yes, at 6 would be this evening.
At Lowe's.
Are you done?
That's sports. Wherever you go, whatever you do, always be a good sport.
Bob, did you bring your gun today?
I did.
Why don't you shoot Chick in front of Todd so we have a witness?
I figured if I just give Chick the gun, he'll do it himself.
Oh, good point.
Works for me.
Where is the gun?
No, you leave it alone.
Christy!
An update for you in Valhalla, New York. A man was married in a jailhouse ceremony 2 days before sentencing for murdering his bride's previous husband. Joseph Rico was married Monday at the Westchester County Jail. He now faces 25 years to life in prison. He apparently was having an affair with the woman when he shot her husband after he couldn't find a hitman to do it for him.
Oh, well, that's nice. Now he'll be making license plates. Maybe he can do one that says, just married. Put it on your car, honey.
There you go, honey.
Thoughtful gift
think of me.
Yes. We're going to come back with comedian Todd Yon. It's sunny today. Highs in the upper 50s.
All right.
Todd's got his guitar here.
751. Woo!
Burlington Industries.
7:55 at Q95. You're with Bob and Tom. Good morning.
Hope you had a chance last night to listen to the Eagles concert on Q95.
Great show.
Simulcast on MTV. A terrific show. In fact, so good, we're going to rerun the whole thing today at noon. So be sure to be near a radio today at noon and hear the Eagles show. This is a live Eagles show that kind of kicked off their 1994 tour. Once again, the Eagles had to postpone their show here at Deer Creek. That will be the opening show of the 1995 Deer Creek season. But if you want a little bit of a preview, we'll play the whole thing at noon today. In fact, in the next hour, we'll play a song or two from the Eagles.
All right.
From the live concert from last night.
Sounds good.
Joining us in the studio, comedian Todd Yon is here with us. Todd is one of our favorites. Todd is at the Broad Ripple Comedy Club. And I want to thank Todd for letting us use a couple of his fine pieces on a couple of our recent albums.
Well, sure. I appreciate y'all including me. You know, I got to say something just real quick. Before you guys were doing the sports and talking in these voices like that,
yes.
I used to live in a community like that. I used to live in Chapel Hill, North Carolina.
Really?
Where everybody talked just like this because it's a city ordinance. You have to. Everybody's name was Biff, Kip, Muffy, Sissy, Poopoo, Cucka, Doodoo, Wee Wee.
Wow.
And I know people like this, and what bothers me is I just couldn't imagine having sex with them. What would they say in a moment of passion? It would scare the daylights out of you. Pitch black, you're about to make the best move of your life. The last thing I need to hear is, oh, my God. Eat me like a cannibal. Ride me, Muffy. Ride me. Spank my honey. I've been a bad yuppie and pass a gray poupon. People like that don't come. They arrive.
Yes, I understand.
RSVP. Oh, my God, a lemon wedge. How thoughtful.
Oh, dear.
That'll wake you up, you little bastard.
Well, good morning, Todd. Long time no see. It's been a couple of years.
I had a brief stint in the radio biz.
I heard that you were a disc jockey.
What?
Somewhere. Yeah, down in Orlando, and I was doing great until my partner sold me out. So it was a lengthy run of 3 months.
Uh-huh.
The first week we were hired, he went out and bought a $20,000 car, $1,500 a month condo, and I'm going, this is radio. And then Stern came to town, and they wanted to turn us into like a morning zoo type of deal, and I said I didn't want to do it, and he said, my ass is in debt, and you can put him back on the road, and I'll stay here in town. So he did, and 3 weeks later, his ass was gone, too. That's radio. I love that job.
Glad
look over my shoulder. What's that in my pooper? Hey, it's the GM. Thanks. Goodness gracious.
General manager, not to imply that any particular automobile manufacturer.
You know, that head shopping thing was really funny.
Oh,
I don't know if you've heard my latest joke. I just heard this joke, and I think it's funny. What's the last thing a stupid redneck says before he dies?
What?
Hey, y'all, watch this! That's my people. Chop.
Oh, Todd, can you grab your guitar and play this?
I can. I haven't written a whole lot since last we were here.
We can do some of the classics.
So you were doing the radio thing, right?
Let me tell one more story, and then we'll get into the music thing. It never ceases to amaze me, these things that I hear on the road and experience that are true, that make a part of my act. 3 weeks ago in South Carolina, I was driving through Rock Hill, South Carolina, when a tornado hit.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't see it. It was on the other side of town. But, you know, tornadoes are a very panicky emergency situation.
Yes, they are.
Apparently not in Rock Hill, South Carolina, because I heard their emergency broadcast network. And this was frightening. I'm not making this up. This is exactly what I hear. Now, keep in mind, this is a panicky situation. It's a tornado.
Mm-hmm.
I'm driving down the road. And I hear, ooh, hi. This is the Rock Hill Emergency Broadcast Network. We would like to report a tornado that has touched down in our fair city. The fire department is tracking it as we speak. They're right behind it. They were following a tornado in a fire truck. That would be like people in Florida. Oh, my God, it's a hurricane. Billy Bob, get the bass boat. Come on. Oh, shoot, it's coming right at us. Put her in reverse. Sound the siren. Whoa, number one to base. We're in the middle of a bunch of trailers up here. You better send out number two. Oh, shoot, it went across the field. We'll never catch it now. Then they signed up by saying, this has been an emergency broadcast message from Rock Hill. See y'all.
See y'all.
And I couldn't believe it.
Well, you're not in Rock Hill. You're in Indianapolis with Bob and Tom this morning on WFBQ WNDE Indianapolis. And Todd Yon is our guest. Todd is at the Broad Ripple Comedy Club. Todd has distinguished himself as a, let me give you some volume here.
There we go.
As a guitar player. He used to tour with the legendary Roy Buchanan.
Yep.
Roy, now deceased. I remember asking you about this once, and you said Roy probably did it as a gag.
He was looking. We tend to feel that he was looking for attention, and just nobody came. He attempted to hang himself, but I'm sure he was thinking, well, the guard will be back here any minute now.
Oh, no.
Oh, something tells me I screwed up big time. So he hung himself, and down he went.
Well, on a lighter note, Todd.
Now here's some Easy Listening by Joan Baez.
Todd picked up some guitar. Let's do a little sound check here. Are we? Okay.
Oh, that's fun.
Little titties, I'm a sister Diane. Two little skeetabites you can hold in one hand. She had an overactive sexual gland. She screwed my cousin and the rest of the band. Oh, yeah! Sing with me, everybody.
Oh, thank you.
I've got more songs that have been stolen from me by artists. It started in the 50s, actually, with Frankie Avalon. Made a big hit out of this one after he stole it from me and changed the words. But I kind of like my version the best. Oh, penis. Oh, penis. Make my wish come true. Oh, penis, if you will. Find me a girl who says she's on the pill. Find me a girl who won't remember my name. Or even if I came. Oh, penis, Adonis of love that you are. Surely the things I ask can't be that great a task. Penis, if you will. Find me a girl and not some dude named Bill. Apparently they don't remember these old ones.
I remember the tune.
I thought it was Venus. Todd Young is our guest. Can you favor us with one of the classics?
Yeah, I can do I'll do a quick country tune. It's about a girl I met in Hawaii who had $40,000 worth of bosom, and I loved her.
Ooh.
And she got off stage, and after I folded up many a dollar bill, she proceeded to tell me that she had hip implants, a butt lift, a tummy tuck, lip injections, cheek implants, a nose job. And the more she talked, the more I realized she didn't have a whole lot left that nature given her. So I wrote this country love song. It's called She Ain't Nothing But a Plastic Bag. Her eyes are blue, her boss and long contacts. Her hair is blonde with roots as black as coal. Her lips have been pumped up like caterpillars. There's just a line where they removed a hairy mole. The facelift that she had proved to be costly. Costly. She had to notify her next of kin. 'Cause it's so hard to go through life like Michael Jackson. For now, her navel's just a dimple in her chin. She ain't nothing but a plastic bag. She won't let nothing on her body sag. Just a nip and tuck, she's on her way. 'Cause she's a queen of plastic surgery. She ain't nothing but a two-bit clone. Big old bosoms filled with silicone. Be careful, boys, if you should cop a feel. 'Cause you won't know if what you're touching's real. Her cellulite done been sucked out by a Hoover. And her butt's as round as any man could want. Her boobs feel like two giant spongy Nerf balls. 'Cause she's a walking testimony for DuPont. And when she smiles just like a beacon. Her teeth are straight in line with both her lips. But she takes them out at night so she can slumber. Then in the morning slaps them back with poly grip. She ain't nothing but a plastic bag. She won't let nothing on her body sag. Just a nip and tuck, she's on her way. 'Cause she's a queen of plastic spray. She ain't nothing but a two-bit clone. Big old boobies filled with silicone. Be careful, boys, if you should cop a fail, because you won't know if what you're touching's real. Well, it's enough to make a body gag. She ain't nothing but a plastic. Hefty scent sack, yellow and blue makes green freezer lock and storage plastic bag.
Bravo.
Oh, thank you very much.
Todd Yon is our guest.
A little Leon Redbone sneaking in there.
Well, old man Lucas had a lot of mucus running out of his nose. Well, he'd pick and pick till it made him sick, and then back again it grows. That's all my best.
Sorry I asked.
That's Todd Yon. Todd is the Broad Ripple Comedy Club. Todd's going to hang out with us this morning.
Hey, y'all, watch this.
We'll come right back.
I want to say one thing. First of all, wait a minute, I'm clenching.
Okay. Go ahead.
Tonight, last night, the Eagles were on the air here with a great live show. Today at noon, we're going to rerun the entire Eagles show, so be sure to get near a radio, go pick up some cassettes so you can record the thing.
All right.
Today at noon, Eagles live. We'll play an Eagles song after the news and sports.
Whenever that is.
Well, ye of little faith. In the next 2 hours, I guarantee we will play
two
songs.
There we go. You're much better off doing that. It's 8:06. Machine. Tom wasn't prepared.
What are we doing up back here already?
Well, you see, you were just talking and telling stories, and just time flies by when you're having fun.
I guess so.
Just don't yell that out when you're not ready again.
I thought that was a joke. I thought you were kidding. Your headphones weren't on. I don't see the lights on in here.
I was taken by surprise.
Well,
how many times did he say that in one sentence?
Just once. No.
Fine.
I don't think anyone heard it. All right. Well, believe it or not, it's time for the news.
How could it be? I was just going over there.
It truly is. Yeah.
The news, huh?
Yeah, the news.
The news in Q95 is... Where's our new staff?
Oh, check! Oh, Christy!
Oh, staff!
It's time for the news!
Oh, check! Oh, Christy! We're on the air! Okay.
All right.
Thank you very much.
All right.
Wow. Comedian Todd Yon is here with us.
Oh, don't look for me to bail you out. You guys...
No. We're just introducing you so people know whose voice that is in the background.
Oh, yeah.
Probably this paging machine isn't working anymore.
Must not be. There's Christy.
Attention, Christy. Attention, chick. We're live.
You want fries with that?
Hi, Christy.
You don't give me enough time to get the news ready anymore.
I beg your pardon?
Wah, wah, wah.
She was just here.
I was just here. Well, I left at 5 till 8.
Nice to see you.
Why don't we postpone the news for a few minutes, and let's let Todd do a quick tune for us. How about that?
Okay.
Todd Yon is here with us. Todd is at the Broad Ripple Comedy Club, and Todd is familiar to many of our listeners, particularly because of Todd's very fine contributions to our various charity album projects. Could we go back to one of the ones that you... we used on one of the albums?
I don't see why not. We can do a song about my dad if you want.
Sure.
Sure.
I didn't see my dad a lot as a kid. He traveled quite a bit. Mm-hmm. He used to hate to go into work, and we used to hate to see him go. So I wrote this song about the old days. It's called Daddy, Please Don't Go. Could I have a little blue lighting for this one, please? Thank you. Don't make me go in there. I was just passing by. I don't want to go in there, because I know if I take just one whiff, I'll die. 'Cause Daddy's been in there. He took the paper along, and he's been in there for hours. And for a while, Mom and I was sure that something was wrong. But he said he was reading. But I think something's amiss. 'Cause if my dad was just reading, then how in the hell could our bathroom ever smell like this? Daddy, please don't go. Daddy, please don't go. Daddy, before you go into your trance, give the rest of the family a chance to get in there before you go. Before you go. 'Cause the wallpaper's peeling. The fumes are out in the hall. They just bounced off of the freaking ceiling and flew up my nose and just flattened me against the wall. Sing along, Daddy, please don't go.
That's right.
Daddy, please don't go.
God bless you, yes.
Daddy, before you go into your trance, give the rest of the family a chance to get in there before you go. Before you go. You smelly phone. Daddy, please don't go. Thank you. I'm available for church gatherings.
Yeah, I'll bet you are.
Bring on the toilet boy.
An emotional encounter with the lost father of
Thank you so much,
comedian.
Todd.
Yeah.
Time for us to switch gears and check in with the news.
Brought to you by Kahlo Jeep Eagle. Come on in and say hello to Kahlo. I love this song. This is our annual Halloween spook song. Ooh, ooh, ah, Indiana's largest seller of Jeeps and Eagles.
I'm scared. Halloween
spooks. No.
I wish that the children could see, but I can't find them for the life of me. And there's Halloween spooks outside my window pane.
And then they start making noise.
How are you going to do the commercial?
A huge sale of 95s is now in progress at Ooh, Kahlo. Including Jeep Grand Cherokees, Cherokees, and Wranglers. Stop it. Stop at Kahlo today and
Could
talk
turn
to
this off?
Peter Kahlo.
God, is that irritating.
Or son Kevin about your new Jeep or Eagle. Kahlo Jeep Eagle.
Spell it.
K-A-H-L-O. And it says it rhymes with follow. Kahlo.
Kahlo.
Kahlo, Kahlo.
But what they do, they say hello to Kahlo. See, so you think Kahlo would rhyme with Kahlo?
All these years I thought it was Kahlo. It's Kahlo?
Kahlo.
Kahlo. As in,
Kahlo. 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 Kahlo, your star. Something.
What song is that?
And that's Kahlo.
It's Kahlo from the Fantastics.
Wow. Very nice, Bobby.
That's the French thing, right?
I think so.
Kahlo Jeep Eagle on Connor Street, Route 32, next to Riverview Hospital in Noblesville. That's Kahlo, rhymes with follow. So say hello to Kahlo. I thought it rhymed with hello.
I thought it was Kahlo. My friend bought his Jeep there. I thought it was Kahlo.
Kahlo.
Every time I'd be behind him in the thing going, could you possibly go any faster? I'd be thinking he got it at Kahlo. I see their little sticker.
Rhymes with Kahlo.
We'll see. That's
Kahlo. 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 Kahlo.
I thought you were
going to
jump into Flipper there for a second.
They call it Kahlo, 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 four-wheel drive star.
You guys are great dolphins. All
right. He might need to hang on to both those talents, fellas. It is time for the news with Christy Lee. Christy, good morning once again.
Man. Good morning. Sunny today. Look for a high of 58 degrees.
Is it time for my break yet?
Yep. I was trying to go get mine in a minute ago, and suddenly the things were over.
I got mine in.
Yeah, we noticed.
Okay, fine. Oh, shit. Chick, I don't want to hear about this. Thank you.
Oh, it was.
All right.
Sorry.
Well, good morning. Here's what's making news headlines around the world. President Clinton doesn't appear to have much to offer Israel after his meeting with Syria's president.
Where's your glasses?
My glasses are on.
Not
See?
You, Tom. Put your glasses on.
They're reading glasses. I'm not reading right
now. Put them on.
I don't start reading until sports starts.
They look. They look swell. Put them on. Come on, put them on.
These are for reading. Ta-da.
Okay.
What?
There's nothing wrong with those glasses. They're very nice.
They look like Mr. Slate's glasses in the Flintstones.
They're big. What do you call these glasses?
Tortoise shell.
Tortoise shell, because the wire rims I got, the headphones crushed them.
So some poor turtle died for your glasses?
They're fake tortoise shell. Okay.
They're not made out of real turtles.
Not real tortoise.
Okay, now I can.
Then we had.
Can we go on now, please?
We can listen to the news.
President Clinton doesn't appear to have much to offer Israel after his meeting with Syria's president.
So, in other words, his relationship to Israel is the same one he has with our country. Nothing to offer.
Nothing to offer at all.
Exactly.
After this morning's talks with Hafez Assad.
Hafez. Yitzhak Smark Wad Farquhar.
Rhymes with Kahlo.
Clinton reported some progress toward an Israel-Syria peace agreement. He offered no details, though. He'll meet with Israeli Prime Minister Yitzhak Rabin later today. All eyes were poised for history at the Israel-Jordan peace treaty signing yesterday when First Lady Hillary Clinton and Jordan's Queen Noor were spotted wearing...
Hold it. Queen what?
N-O-O-R.
Noor.
Queen Noor. We're spotted wearing very similar pale blue business suits, as reported in the USA Today. Both momentarily stopped in their tracks, dropped their jaws, then continued walking as if nothing had happened.
I believe the word bitch may have... Bob, you said that.
Exactly.
I think somewhere in the synapse the word you.
But apparently it was too late. The crowd, including security officials, burst out laughing. Guests turned on video cameras to capture what one called the ultimate Kodak moment.
Well, I'm certainly glad that a moment of this kind of historic importance is being
reduced to
a fashion. When Clinton and Noor sat down next to each other, they both pulled out brown sunglasses with nearly identical styles, again, both pretending not to notice.
Clinton, there's a picture
of Leo Rabin of Israel there.
Let's see the picture.
Queen Noor is the one, is the American that married.
She's the American.
Yes, the very attractive young woman who married.
Oh, you know, Bill King is Hassan. Like, Bill is salivating over
there. I wonder what she's like.
Mm-hmm. Oh, man.
Well.
And then there's Mrs. Rabin.
There's Mrs. Rabin, somewhat outclassed by a...
Nice.
Poor lady.
Well, that's
Barbara
very nice.
Bush of
this
the
is pretty spooky. This is sort of the same outfit.
Mm-hmm. Same color. Nearly the same color.
Wow. Yeah. Well, I wonder what that Mr. Blackwell has to say about this. He's probably completely hysterical.
It's a fashion don't.
I think she should have gone with the pink pillbox hat thing, kind of that.
Oh, yeah.
Kind of that sort of.
I think that's in the First Lady Book of Rules.
Yeah.
Never do the pillbox hat.
What a drag.
Never. Number one.
Never.
I'd like to contribute to the late Halston.
I'm going with the pink pillbox, kind of a.
Yeah.
Well, this would remind Bill to stay in the bubble top this week.
Yes.
Put the bubble top on.
Mm-hmm. The evidence fight heats up again today in the O.J. Simpson case. Judge Lance Ito scheduled to hold a hearing on a defense request to toss out yet again evidence seized from Simpson's Bronco. First, though, there'll be more questioning of prospective jurors. Yesterday, 13 members of the jury pool questioned, 7 sent home because they admitted they'd broken the media ban, an 8th person dismissed for hardship reasons. The jury is expected to begin deliberations in the Tailhook case today after hearing closing arguments. Now, this is Paula Coughlin's suit against the hotel where
where it was held. She says the Las Vegas Hilton didn't provide adequate security during the 91 convention.
You just have to follow her around when she attends a cocktail party.
Yeah, I guess. The recently expanded and renovated Indiana Convention Center has won the Monumental Affair Award for Architectural Design and Development in an annual celebration of local construction achievements, according to the Indianapolis Star this morning. So congratulations to those in the know.
And I might want to find out
so we awarded ourselves the award, is that it? It's a local award, not a national award?
No.
Isn't that the name of Warren Beatty's new movie, Monumental Affair?
No, that's Monumental Bomb.
Oh, never mind.
The Monumental Affair Awards, initiated in 1977 and presented in conjunction with local architect and interior design associations, celebrates the achievements of construction, design, and development from July of 91 to July of 94. So, yes, they are local.
Okay, thank you.
Yes. It's a very nice building. Very, very.
Yes, it is.
Would have assumed that a monumental affair would have gone to our president.
Well, he's not, yeah, he's not out of Jordan yet, or wherever the hell he is.
With Queen Noor.
Noor, Noor.
I want to say Noor you, yeah.
None of the tickets sold for
Foxy
Powerball.
Lady. How about some Dubage Queen Noor?
You know.
I understand you went to Princeton.
I'm the president, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a Rhodes Scholar.
You know, your husband's kind of swarthy, wouldn't you say?
A little older, though.
Probably like someone a little more Caucasoid.
And he wears a towel on his head.
If you know what I mean.
No, he never does, wink. I don't think. He's about 5 foot.
Ooh. Yeah, he's tiny.
He's
tiny,
a tiny man.
Tiny man.
Mm.
Yep.
How fitting for a tyrant.
No Napoleonic complex there.
No, not at all.
It's so handy. Uh-huh. I will get myself a tall American wife. I will show them I am just like an American. I want to be James Dean, although heterosexual.
None of the you've ruined my day.
I think I can.
Where have you been, Christy?
I guess I was in another world. I don't know. I had no idea.
So there's a big book about
very well documented
that right now, apparently. Well, Salminio was real tight with him.
Oh, no. I don't want to know these
things. You heard about Salminio?
Oh, yeah. Big flamer.
Like, well, Sal, I can picture, but not with James Dean.
Why not? Look out.
I don't know, Sal.
I would like to say good morning to all my friends in Fairmount.
Talk about method acting. Hello.
Now the tickets sold for the Powerball game Wednesday night matched all six numbers drawn. That means the Powerball jackpot grows to an estimated $11 million for Saturday. This year's winner of the messiest home office in America nearly missed out on the
Tom
dubious
Griswold.
Honor. Clive Miller says he was sent a copy of the Home Office Computing Magazine contest rules but misplaced it. Well, that should come as no surprise since the 56-year-old Claremont, California man's home office is piled high with old bank statements, investment magazines, and his plastic in-and-out trays hopelessly crammed with paperwork.
Sounds like my office.
It does sound like your office. I think next year we're going to have to enter you in
notice
that contest.
The office has been clean.
Notice the office is clean?
Yeah, I noticed that.
It won't stay that way.
Well, look at this over here. I mean, pretty soon he'll have this little area right in here.
Yeah.
Mess.
It's already started.
It's my area. I can do with it what I want. Thank you.
Well, sure you can. Jeans may not be considered high fashion, but blue denim is being given blue blood treatment at a museum in Paris. The museum display in the fashion capital traces the history of blue jeans from cowboys to couture. The story of jeans also displays denim of some famous folks. There are blow-ups of Marlon Brando and James Dean in their jeans.
When Marlins were the Huskies.
Lauren.
James had the zipper in the mouth. James Dean.
Lauren McCall's velvet bell-bottom jeans are on display, and then there's David Bowie's denim. A denim jockstrap.
James Dean. There's no need to feel down. I said
James Dean. Pull
yourself off the ground. I said
James Dean.
Cause you're in a new town.
Ooh.
Sorry.
Whee! Just out of sports in Taylorsville, Illinois, Carson and Barnes, the five-ring circus, ended a run there, leaving behind a six-ton elephant that apparently died of natural causes.
Jeez.
The 60-year-old Kay had traveled with the circus through three generations of show people, but she was buried by a local excavating company.
Her last words were...
A 60-year-old elephant.
And they just left it there.
You know, she tied... They
what
tied
are they
their,
supposed to do with it, Christy?
They could have had a funeral for it or something.
Nah, just leave it there. It'll decompose.
During the circus, they would they would tie the two elephants. They'd get another elephant along and tie their trunks together.
Yeah.
You know what the elephant said?
What?
What did you do that for?
What did you do that for?
What did you do that for?
Very effective. Thank you.
We mean, did the circus bury it, or did the circus just leave us?
They just left it. And they, the elephant joke, local excavating company buried the elephant.
That had to be a really expensive proposition to bury an elephant. Did they have to drive it somewhere?
Can't we just eat it?
Eat it?
Eat it?
When was the last time you had an elephant burger?
Well, how do you know you haven't ever had an elephant
burger? Not just any elephant.
Oh, that's
that's aged beef right there.
Yeah.
60 years of aged
couldn't
beef.
Couldn't you eat an elephant burger? I bet you could.
I don't know.
Isn't that endangered species thing kicking in on the elephant?
Tastes like chicken.
I bet it does.
Tastes like snail darter, actually.
Tastes a little bit like a spotted owl. And you know, spotted owl tastes kind of like eagle. We had that eagle roast last year.
Those are more like condor.
Yeah, that's true. It's hard to get a good condor, though.
Terrible aftertaste, man.
Yeah. You need to get them fresh. You need to get the condor fresh.
Time to take a break and come back with sports.
You bet it is. It's 8:29.
Hi, I'm
34 Q95.
Good morning, sports fans. Bob, Tom, Christy, Blank Man, Todd.
Chick.
Antonio Davis last night started for the Pacers exhibition game at Market Square Arena and made the most of it. 18 points, 11 rebounds led the Pacers to a 113-104 victory over the Charlotte Hornets. Rick Smith, Dale Davis, and Derek McKee sitting out because they're tired. Reggie had 18 points. Thank you. Blank Man. Don Majkowski has been named the starter of the Colts-Jets game coming up this Sunday at 4 o'clock, and I don't know who we have here. Oh, yeah. Hey. Here's starting quarterback Don Majkowski talking about looking forward to the game against the Jets.
Q95, who's this?
Good morning, Senator Kennedy.
How are you?
I'm on the turnpike. I hope you can hear me all right. We're throwing $100 bills out the window right now, getting more voters.
Oh, well, good.
Good luck.
Yes, thank you. Boy, I tell you, I've had too much to drink this morning. I've been, I knew I did when I was out kissing people and shaking babies. God, I hate that when it happens.
Can you,
Hey, listen.
Do you have an exotic drink that you enjoy?
I most certainly do. It's called a Chappaquiddick.
Really?
It's a, yes, scotch and murky water.
Fine. Thank you.
This is Majkowski or Harbaugh. I'm not sure which one.
It's Majkowski.
You sure?
And we're watching the films from that game and so forth. I'm going to study that a lot and, you know, try to see some tips and so forth that maybe we might be able to improve on, because you know, they did some things that were pretty effective against us, and hopefully we can do a better job in some areas this time.
And now here's second string quarterback, I guess, Jim Harbaugh.
So I'm fully behind Don and in his corner, and I'll do the best I can to
push him
out and help the rest of the team, and mainly just prepare myself for him needed again.
Yeah, right. Okay. And be sure to join us for a rally in the alley at Jimmy Mad Dog Made Us Sunday at 1 o'clock, Jackson Street. Beer and burgers, only a buck. Hey. Only in America. Only from Q95. Indianapolis, huh?
That's a good deal.
That is a good deal. Ice beat the Chicago Wolves in the International Hockey League last night by a score of 5-3. The Indianapolis Ice in Kalamazoo tomorrow night at Market Square Arena. A post-game concert with the Village People tomorrow night. I will be your host. That's right, me, Chick, Mr. Disco. Thank you. Thank you.
There's a Village People look-alike contest or something?
Yeah, you're supposed to come dressed as your favorite Village person, I guess.
Oh.
And you could win fabulous prizes. Hockey lockout has reached 27 days. Out of work star Wayne Gretzky has told the Toronto Sun, "I've just been laying the pipe with the missus." But he's also
not
planning.
What he said.
Who's he married to? Janet. What's her name?
Yeah, Janet Jones.
Janet Jones?
Yeah.
Is that her?
Yeah.
Was she on Three's Company?
No, she wasn't on Three's Company.
Oh, okay, never mind.
She's in the Firm video. She did that workout video.
She's got a workout video.
Oh, yeah. She's one of the early ones. Yeah. One of the very first.
She's in a cheesy movie. With
oh, that's
Mitch
right. She looks like a greyhound, Jim doesn't she? Kind of like a greyhound.
Kinda, yeah.
Really sharp nose.
She was with Three Guys.
What?
No, where'd you get that?
Three Guys in the workout video? Yeah, it's called Three's Company. You've seen it.
Oh, Three's Company.
No.
Oh, I thought. Never mind. I'm confused. Would that be a hat trick?
That would be the hat trick. Three guys in the workout
guys
video.
At the same time.
See, I knew there was something down that comedic vein. No,
you're right.
I'm sorry, if I paid attention, I could have been a little more in tune with the setup there.
Chipping away at it.
Something will, you'll hit.
So Wayne Gretzky is with three guys?
No.
That's what I heard.
Just move on, please.
Was he the Village People? Was he the hockey guy in the Village People?
Yeah, he was the hockey guy.
Wayne That's Gretzky. High sticking.
Gay as the day's long. Frank Thomas named the American League most valuable player. Not that there's anything wrong with that.
Mm-hmm.
Frank Thomas, way to go. He won the MVP and won a...
Should know Rainbow Boy.
Got a lot of more...
Nancy Mary.
Rainbow Boy. You know, as a joke, friends, let me talk to you as a listener just a second. As a joke, we decided to order away for a catalog aimed at the discriminating homosexual male in America. It's called Shocking Gray Catalog. And guess whose name they decided to use to order the catalog?
Whose?
Mine. So now I'm...
Gay boy.
So now I'm getting all kinds of interesting mail.
Oh, really?
And really, really crappy looks from the lady who sorts the mail.
Here's your latex penis magazine.
I just took a quick look at it and, well... Thanks a lot. My friggin' life.
I could say something right now, but it wouldn't be worth the lawsuit.
The grief and lawsuit.
But could I write it down for the guys?
Yes.
Sure, why don't you? National League MVP will be named today. Look for Jeff Bagwell to win that. Players Union gets another visit from Bill Usheray today as the federal mediator continues to gather information on the baseball strike.
Just for friends.
However...
Okay.
Gotcha.
All righty.
Here, burn that.
Really?
That'll go in the book. Okay. It looks like good news for pro basketball fans. Management and the Players Union are going to sign an agreement. No strike, no lockout pledge. That would allow the negotiations to continue to hammer out an agreement, but the season start next Friday night on time will not be delayed for once. Sports this morning brought to you by Dreyer and Reinbold Infinity, now offering the Q45.
Q45.
A luxury sedan that will fulfill your every expectation. $50 and a Q45.
We should get a $50 bill and a Q45, give it away. It's the Q95 giveaway.
That's right.
Lease the Q45 for as low as $499 a month for 36 months and feel this exceptional driving experience. The Q45 features leather interior, driver and passenger side airbags, anti-lock brakes, power sunroof,
you ever sat in the Q45, Chris?
Seats, locks, and much
no,
more.
No, I don't think I ever have.
I'll tell you what, it grips your buns like a teenage boy in a first date.
Really?
And I was worried about
that. Takes me way back.
Tom Griswold.
No, I meant a boy with
Christy. Oh, me.
I'm sorry, I meant with Christy.
I knew what he meant.
How would you know?
Not my buns.
I thought you there at Byron Junior High.
No, sorry. No.
It was an all-guy school, wasn't it?
No, not Byron.
Oh. University was, though, wasn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, yeah. No, I never partook.
I was offered, but I did not partake.
I have the school fight song.
Yeah! I'm sorry. Dryan Reinbold Infinity, I-465 and Keystone Avenue. And that's sports.
It is.
Yep, wherever he is, goes, whatever he is, does, always be a good sport. Christy?
This is kind of a sad way to end our news, but a man who shot and killed a doctor at a crowded Tokyo railway station was apparently a patient dissatisfied with his hernia operation.
Mm-hmm.
The gentleman is still at large. He fired a pistol into the doctor's back in front of hundreds of morning rush hour commuters.
Killed the doctor?
Yeah, he killed him dead.
Yow.
Out of deference to the doctor, though, he loaded the gun with an old magazine. So the
bada boom, bada bing. Oh, yeah.
See, I was poor thinking fella. Hernia.
Yeah.
Magazine! Bad waiting room material.
Yes.
Bingo!
Look, I'm right back.
Like comedy.
842. Hi there, 846 at Q95. You're with Bob and Tom. Good morning. Maybe we should rethink this thing.
I don't know where we are. I'm sorry. I was out of the room. Hang on for 1 second. I want to try something. Why doesn't this work? Oh, Christy. could you come into the control room, please? I know that you're busy doing the news, but never mind. Okay, we'll see if we can get her back in here. Does the speaker thing, is it hooked up over there
yet? I have no idea. Okay. I haven't, want me to go outside and find out?
No, I'll send a chick out there. See, I want to see if this works. Hang on a second. Okay. Oops. Attention. Oh, does the speaker go back to your room already? No?
I had the radio on back there.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry.
I was washing my hands and...
Washing your hands. After being on this program, I wash my hands every day.
I wash my hands a lot around here.
In fact, I wash them almost
shower after
almost
every show.
Compulsively. After today's show,
too.
I'm
going to
need a colonic.
What did you call me in here for?
Well, nothing. We'll talk about it in a minute. And now that you're here, we'll just take a seat. And let's we've been ignoring our special guest. Todd Yon is here from the...
And for good reason.
Broderful. Fine. Good. From the Broderful Comedy Club. Before we... And Todd, we're going to ignore you for one more minute while I tell people that we had so much interest in last night's Eagles concert on Q95. We're going to replay the whole show today at noon. This is a live Eagles show.
Outstanding.
And in fact, after Todd performs here for a moment, we're going to play you an Eagles show, an Eagles song, rather, from the live show last night.
Right.
Okay. Todd Yon is here with us. Todd is from North Carolina, and he's a distinguished musician. He used to tour with the great and the legendary Roy Buchanan. And Todd now is a touring stand-up comedian. He's been on our show many times and was... very nice to let us use a couple of his pieces on our charity projects, and they've been very successful and raised a lot of money for charity. So thanks to Todd in advance. Now, you just told me you have a brand new tune.
Well, I got it. It's not brand new. It's just a tune that you've never heard before.
Oh.
But
okay, good.
Well, I have a quick one before that. It's kind of a mellow tune, and then I'll pick it up with them.
Okay.
Are the stars out tonight? I don't care if it's cloudy or bright, 'cause I'm blind. I'm blind as a... Oh.
Fine.
You guys are twisted little sisters. There's a little brown spot on my underwear. Here's a song you haven't heard before.
Okay.
It's a nasty song about a nasty man. I wrote it about myself.
Hey.
Talks about the trials and tribulations of having red hair everywhere. It's called Red on the Head, like the wee-wee of a big old dog blues. Hope you like it. I was in a bar on Friday with a girl named of Claire. She had a really nice body. She had a really big pair. I took her back to my place, took off my clothes and she stared. She said, well, hey, baby, I can't do you, 'cause you got red pubic hair. Red on the head, like the wee-wee of a big old dog blues. Sometimes my red hair makes me so blue. I wish my pubes were blue, too. Well, wouldn't you? So I went with a woman by the name of Lavon. I could tell that babe was kinky. She was sucking down bonbons. I went on back to her place, got naked with the lights on. But when I looked at her, I had to laugh, 'cause all her pubes was gone. Red on the head, like the wee-wee of a big old dog blues. She was a bald mama, looked just like a bell pepper. Sometimes my red hair makes me so blue. I wish my pubes were blue, too. Well, wouldn't you?
Oh, yes.
So I went to the gym to play basketball with the bros. I couldn't slam, don't drive or shoot, and I couldn't grow no fro. So I went on to the showers with a big old blood named Ned. Well, I looked at him, he looked at me, he said, man, your pubes be red. Red on the head, like a wee-wee of a big old dog blues. How embarrassing. Sometimes my red hair makes me so blue. Sing with me, won't you?
No.
I wish my pubes were blue, too. Sometimes my red hair makes me so blue. I wish my pubes were blue. I wish my pubes. I wish my pubes. Pew, pew. Pew, pew. Pew, pew, pew. Ow. Little tiny pew. Little curlify. Little crispy, crunchy curlify. Won't get soggy milk, no, sir. Little curly things on my bathtub floor. They won't go down the drain. They won't go down the drain. Drain-o, no drain. If I had Drain-o, they'd go down the drain. I wish my pews were blue, too. That's right.
Wow.
Todd Young is our guest here.
Oh, my parents are proud of me.
Oh, yeah.
A pioneer, certainly.
I'd say you were run out of Orlando.
Well.
Well, we'll move on.
Thanks, Todd. That was very moving, and I think a lot of red-haired people out there are...
I'm sure they can relate.
Oh, we're singing the blues with you.
We're starting a support group.
Do we have time to...
We've got it. We're ready to roll.
Okay, this is a to change the subject only slightly.
Mm-hmm.
This is a live song from the Eagles. This entire concert will be rebroadcast today on Q95 at noon.
Noon. Don't miss it.
Eagles Live.
This is the Eagles Live, Life in the Fast Lane, Q95.